Hey, what's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hi, hello, my name's Lydia. As you can see, I've got no makeup on. I cried it off. Sorry, not sorry. I feel like crap at the moment. I feel ill. Physically and mentally. Today, I thought I'd do a bit of a story time, but the angle I chose isn't working.
Don't let me drown. Don't let me drown.
This video is one that I never thought I was going to make. My mom decided to start on me today because I made a post on Facebook for the first time ever talking about the year I've had. And put it very bluntly, this is what my mom said to me that pissed me off. My mom's reaction to my mental health has never been good. Ever. Which is why she is never involved in anything that goes on. As you guys have seen, my family are very disconnected from what I do in my life. And that's my choice. Because, and I can explain this, the very first time that I went to A&E for my mental health was when I was suicidal. And now, feeling suicidal, you don't think, oh, what, my mum's doing this. Oh, but this is going on. You want to die. I managed to get myself to A&E because I was under 18. Parents had to come and collect me. And my mom was doing this college course, which I fully respect. Whatever, fine, you know. She didn't turn up. My stepdad did. Fine, you know, I got to go home. I got referred to CAMS and that was fine. Until I got home. My mom's first words to me were, Lydia, I was at college. I didn't need your attention-seeking behaviour right now. And that she, since then, I don't talk to her about my mental health. She only finds out if she accidentally stumbles across, like, one of my tweets or something. Like she doesn't know anything that goes on. And she started to start on me today, saying, why are you posting this for our family to see? Why are you so outspoken? Why does it matter to you that much? And it's like, because mental health is not a taboo subject. We should not be afraid to talk about it. There's no shame in talking about it. I'm not going to back down just because you don't like it. Like, I'm going to speak my mind. I'm going to say what's going on. And the first time ever, I spoke on Facebook about my friend who killed herself this year, and I don't talk about this a lot because it still doesn't affect me a lot. Don't my mom fucking text me, which your friends killed themselves. My mom doesn't know any of my friends in real life. She's never met any of them, but she felt the need to comment on it. And I respect and understand that I'm her daughter, right? I get that. She kicked me out. She has hated every bit of involvement. And when it comes to me being admitted, people are always like, oh, why don't you ask your mum to come and help you? As I put screenshot earlier, this is why. I've never asked her to drop everything and come to A&E. I've never asked her to drop everything and come visit me in hospital. In fact, she's visited me during, what, two of my admissions in my life. Like, my mum does not have that much involvement in my life. My friends have been to see me in hospital more than my mum has. And that breaks me. Like, I wish my mum cared. And I wish I had my mum there. But I don't. I don't live in that world. I don't live in a world where I have a supportive family. I live in a world where I have a really fucked up family who don't want to be in my life and who feel like they have some right to tell me what I can and can't put on Facebook about people who I care about. I put in that post about being in hospital, about trying to kill myself. I put really raw things on that, and I don't. Anyone who knows me, who has me on Facebook knows, I don't post on Facebook about me. I will share stuff, I'll post photos, whatever. I don't write statuses. We go weeks and then months sometimes without even sending a text to each other. And now she's like, why didn't you tell me? Why didn't you tell me? And I was like, I did tell you. Like, I told you when I was, like, in February when I was in Milton Keynes. I told my mum about that admission and it broke me. It fucking broke me. Like, when I found out that she knew, I was crying, I was panicking, and I didn't know how to react. And even then she was like, I'm not dropping everything for you. And I was like, I didn't ask you to. I would love to say that if I was in crisis, I could pick up a phone and just call my mum. But I can't. Because if I did that, do you know what she'd say? I've got work in the morning, Lydia. Because of what she's read online about me peeing, she thinks that everything's for attention. Like, my whole social media platform, my YouTube channel, my Twitter, my Instagram, my Facebook page, what's it all built up on, guys? Mental health. This channel started out as a mental health channel. I know I've progressed into other areas, but at its core, we talk about mental health because mental health affects all of us. We all have a mental health. Some of us have mental illness. It's as real as a physical illness. It's as real as cancer. And you know what? Absolutely fuck the stigma. I'm so done. I always avoid talking about my family on here. I don't talk about my family issues on YouTube. I've avoided it for a long time, you know? A long time. Like, I've been on YouTube since I was, what, 11? 11? It's been over 10 years, you know? Like, it's how she's treated me. at the moment. I'm not going to drop everything every time you're in hospital. I wish I had a mom who cared. I do. I wish I had a family that wasn't fucked up. Like, I'm talking about my mom here. Like, I haven't even gotten to my dad's side of the family, which is even more fucked up than my mom's side. It irritates me. Because I'm never going to be enough for her. I'm never going to be able to prove that what I have going on is as real as her fucking diabetes. Like, I'm never going to be able to prove that. Because she's only ever researched BPD. She's never researched dissociative disorder. She's never researched anxiety. She's never researched depression. Even though, fun fact, my family have a history of bipolar. My mom knows BPD, based off what she sees on Google. Stigmatizing. Why not read real people's experiences? Why not look at what that condition actually is? I just wish my mom knew what she was saying before she said it. Like, she's always been like, oh, well, if I say this, you're gonna even kill yourself. I don't want to tell you because you're gonna even kill yourself over it. She treats suicide like it's some simplistic thing, and it's not. It's actually insulting when she does that. I hope you guys have enjoyed this little mini rant. I had to do this. I had to have a rant somewhere, and YouTube's apparently the only place I'm allowed to say what I think. Anyway, I'm gonna go. I'm on my meds. I'm not going to sleep. I'll end this in the morning. Or tonight. I don't know. We'll see. I'm pissed off. Good night, guys.